brush tool is perfect for creating freeform shapes that have a ton of style and texture. Any path in Vectornator can be turned into a brush, and with our brush editing panel, you can create any shape you can think of. Now, as we pick up the brush tool from the toolbar, a slider pops up. Adjusting this slider will edit the stroke width of your path. For example, this is a very fine brush. It almost looks like a regular path. But if we amp up the width, then we can clearly see its unique shape. Speaking of regular paths, you can turn any path in Vectornator into a brush stroke. Here, I'm using the pen tool to create a simple curve. It's the same pen tool that we know and love, but I can change the aesthetic of this curve by simply going to the inspector and clicking on the brush button here. Now, it looks just like the last brush preset that I used. The same thing applies to paths created with the pencil tool, of course. And the same for the shape tool. There's a lot of amazing stuff that can be created by applying cool brush paths to basic shapes. Since a regular path and a brush path are so interchangeable, this also means that brush paths can be edited just like any other vector path or shape in Vectornator. So with the node tool in hand, you can move your nodes around. You can adjust their handles, you can delete them, or you can transform their type. It's right here in the inspector. Here's a quick tip that will save you a lot of time. If you're looking to change an angular node to a rounded one, just double-click on it. And if you want to delete any extra nodes in your path in just a few seconds, adjust the smoothing level here. The higher the smoothing level, the more our AI will clean up the path and adjust it to have as few nodes as possible. Alright, now let's look at the different brush profiles that you can choose from and how to create your own. If you click on this arrow here, you'll notice that we have 8 presets at the bottom, and your own custom brushes will appear at the top. Let's create one now. Just click on the brush editor and a panel will appear. We have 5 parameters that we can play around with. The shape of your brush can easily be changed by simply clicking and dragging on either of these 2 nodes. And I say either because whatever change you make here will be symmetrical. As you adjust your shape, notice the roundness and the angle changing as well. The easiest way to see the effect of roundness is by checking what the end of our brush looks like. And the easiest way to notice the angle is by creating a really flat brush. Now, you can see how the angle completely changes the look of your brush stroke. The minimum width will have the most effect on areas in your path that are very thin. So if we look at the end of the brush stroke here, this is what happens when we adjust it. But arguably the most visual and noticeable way to change your brush shape is in the contour panel. It's a favorite on our team. This shape behaves like any other Vectornator path, meaning that I can drag the nodes around. I can add new nodes by clicking anywhere on the line, or I can delete them by right-clicking and pressing delete. Once you're happy with your brush, save it, and now you'll be able to find it in the selection panel up top. And if you have iCloud Sync enabled, all of your custom brushes will be synced between your iPhone, iPad, and Mac, so that you can create anywhere you go. These are the ins and outs of our brush tool on Mac. If you want to get started with a custom brush pack, created by our one and only in-house illustrator extraordinaire, you'll find the download link in the description below. That's all for today. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you all in our next video. Bye!